Hey guys, Denise Salcedo here with Instinct Culture, and today we are in Hollywood for the premiere of the 350 Days movie. Paul, first of all, nice to meet you. Great t-shirt.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks. This is a Roots of Fight special. I love this company.
Awesome. So, you know, I have to tell you, you do pretty much everything underneath the sun. You do stunt work, you do acting, you do, podcasting, so much. What is the most difficult thing that you do right now? What would you consider the most difficult?
Right now, it's stunt work for sure, but as my acting career picks up speed and I'm starting to get more complicated roles, that's a whole different kind of challenge, so it's getting tougher.
What's the craziest stunt you've done?
That would be when I was doubling Stone Cold Steve Austin in the movie The Stranger, and I had to do something called an air ram. It's like a catapult that you stand on and it throws you, and I had to get thrown up and backward about 15 feet onto my head on the lawn of the adjacent house. It was pretty brutal. I almost broke my neck rehearsing it into pads, and so on the day I was thinking, if it goes wrong again, I'm probably not going to walk away, so I'm glad it went well.
So what made you continue to do that? I mean, with the rehearsal not going so well.
Can't sing, can't dance. I'm not that smart, so I got to do something to pay the bills.
Awesome. And then also, basically, you were able to see Kenny Omega at the early start of his career. Did you think that he was going to be good from then until now?
To be honest, I didn't know that he was going to be properly appreciated. I always knew he was tremendously talented. The first time I met him, I had a brief conversation with him in Toronto, and I was really struck by how much he was dedicated to the art of pro wrestling. To him, it wasn't about being big and famous, and although that's what he became. It was more about being the most well-rounded, multi-style wrestler he could possibly become. And so I thought, this guy's going to be really good, but I'm glad that he ended up being a big star, because a lot of talents like him go underappreciated, and I'm glad he didn't.
Yeah, I know, and it's pretty cool because he also went on to say that, now with his championship reign at IW in New Japan, that, he's basically looking to be a different kind of champion, not a textbook champion. So are you surprised at all by that?
No, not at all. I mean, he's always been an outside-the-box guy. That's what got him where he is today, and I'm really glad that the timing worked out. I mean, New Japan it's never been stronger, and he's a power player in New Japan, so he's got so much creative freedom right now on such a big platform that he's really primed to revolutionize the pro wrestling industry through the next few years.
Awesome. And then I know you're also close friends with Brian Alvarez and Dave Meltzer, correct?
Yeah, I know those guys really well, yeah.
Do you have any advice for Brian on his upcoming match?
Yes. Unlike when he was in the ring with me and Dr. Luther about 15 years ago, try to keep your pants on.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, Paul. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. Have a great night.
As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a big fat like. Subscribe to my channel for more. And in the comments below, let me know what you guys thought of all of these interviews and who was your favorite.